All right, welcome back to Netflix and Chill. If you're tuning in, this is the third episode. This is the show where we review everything on Netflix so that you don't have to.
Exactly. So now we're going to go and randomly generate the movie that we're going to watch from the randomizer.
Let's hit up the randomizer.
All right. Here we are at the randomizer.
Here we are again at the randomizer.
Hope for the best.
Yeah, let's pick a good number.
Shake the dice and throw. Roll them. Generate. 996. 1, 2, 3, 4. Big game.
Big game.
President of the United States. You found some tracks?
A shoe.
Shoe.
Looks just like yours. It must be a lucky day.
Lucky day.
All right, so we just finished watching The Big Game.
No, it's called Just Big Game.
Big Game.
Yeah.
Yes. Terry, would you like to tell people what this movie's about?
Okay, I'll try to do that as best as I can. So this is a movie about this boy named Oskari. He's a 13-year-old Finnish boy who is going on his rite to passage, trying to transition from boyhood into manhood. He's with his father going through the wilderness of northern Finland, going on a hunting mission, trying to hunt down some sort of deer. And while he's going hunting, there's also this plot where the president of the United States is getting kidnapped by some sort of terrorists and getting sabotaged by his own Secret Service team. And yeah, then afterwards, the only hope that the president has is this 13-year-old boy when he falls into the forest of northern Finland after Air Force One gets blown up. He goes into this escape pod, which is only accessed from the outside, and he drops into the forest in Finland. Then this 13-year-old boy finds him, and they have to get away from the terrorists, and that's pretty much the movie. Like, apparently this movie has some sort of following, and the movie that he did prior, it's
Rare Exports. And this is actually a really good movie. It's
I haven't seen it, but
it's a creepy Christmas movie. Probably one of the better Krampus stories. And there've been a lot of them recently, but this one actually is pretty good. Stars the same little boy and probably a few of the other Finnish cast members. Written and directed by the same guy, Jalmari Helman.
Rare Exports, A Christmas Tale.
And this was also at the Toronto International Film Festival. Apparently Toronto loves this guy.
That, rightfully so.
All of a sudden I had to pee. So, I dashed off to the toilet to handle my business. And in my haste to get back in time, I sort of prematurely put myself away and the last bit squirted out on the front of my trousers.
So, this movie was made for 8.5 million euros, which is the most ever spent on a movie in Finnish film history. And I think it's fair to say that most of it went to its cast.
For sure.
This movie stars Samuel L. Jackson.
I have the ability to stare at people and not blink.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Who's really no stranger to bad movies. Does anyone remember this little gem right here?
Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane!
And I guess a whole host of other bad movies. He once said that because he was homeless at some point that he would never turn down a movie role, and he's really taking that to heart here. He plays this buffoon president This guy is so incompetent.
Do you come in peace?
Yes. Yes, I come in peace, most definitely. Yes, I do. Wait, don't hang up.
And he also can't do basic things like he has a gun that's like very close to him. It's just right on the refrigerator. And he could kill the bad guy, but clearly, because he's so incompetent, he can't even shoot a gun properly. So the guy comes and he takes the gun away from him and shows him how to cock the gun.
Yeah.
Which sets up one of Samuel L. Jackson's biggest lines in this movie.
You gotta cock it, motherfucker.
And then, you know, we have other cast members like Victor Garbo, the guy from Titanic. He's also a Canadian actor. And his performance was really, you know, we might as well say Victor Garbage, because that's how bad his performance was.
God in heaven! This is the most powerful nation in the history of the planet. Look at me!
It was beautiful.
It was. Those were golden moments. I loved it. That's what really, truly made me laugh.
Mm-hmm. That's what's probably going to earn this thing any beer cans in our rating that we'll get to in a moment.
Like everything you do as an actor, you never know what it's going to be when it's done.
Sort this shit out.
But this movie, the huge comparison for me that I drew upon was this movie's basically E.T., but instead of an alien, they've got Samuel L. Jackson as the president of the United States. He comes down from the skies in what appears to be a flying saucer type vehicle, which is actually an escape pod, that you can't open from the inside. You can only open from the outside. So
stupid.
If you landed in the ocean or in a desert or something like that, you're basically fucked. You're gonna die in there.
Yeah, like what would he do if that little boy wasn't there? He was like writing like the code on the inside. And the thing is too, it's like northern Finland, and yet you don't see anyone's breath or anything in the entire
film.
It's
freezing cold. But they do throw a blanket over Samuel Jackson, which makes him look even more like E.T. And that's good enough, because when you're in the Arctic Circle, remember to bring a blanket. So one of my favorite scenes of this whole movie is a scene that's taken directly from the pages of The Simpsons, the episode where Homer gets trapped in the sensory deprivation tank and falls down the mountain. It's basically shot for shot done the same way in this movie, and it's pretty much just as entertaining. So after hours of talking about this movie, we've decided on a rating for it, and we're going to go with 1 beer can out of 10 beer cans, and I think that that's awfully generous.
I know it's going to upset a lot of people. Apparently, you know, this movie has some sort of following, and
it's the pride of Finland.
But
we love you Finnish viewers out there. No disrespect to your country or to your rites of passage in hunting deer and stuff like that. Actually, that was probably one of the more fascinating elements of the film, and the scenery of Finland is gorgeous.
It is very nice.
Very beautiful country.
Yeah, very beautiful country. But this movie just made me very, very angry, and it was 90 minutes long, but it felt a lot longer than that.
It did. It really stretched
really,
out.
Really, really stretched out. Thank God it's over. That was I hate that movie so much. I'm sorry, I really do.
Sorry, Finland.
And
this one,
I'm going to drink this. I wish I had more. I wish we could give it a higher rating so that, you know, I could kind of kill my brain cells with this, because this is like such a bad movie. So here's to the big game. Here we go.
Heard it here. Big game, Netflix and chill, one beer can out of 10 beer cans. Don't watch this movie. Complete waste of time. Super stupid. If you want to watch a Finnish movie that's actually fun, same cast, same director, Rare Exports. Check this one out. Until next time.
Oh, and remember to subscribe to our channel and tune in for our episode next week.
Every Friday.
Where we hopefully review something a lot better than this movie that we did this week.
Please God.
F*** you, Samuel L. Jackson.